Let's go see what the disaster is. Okay. Scott, if you're good at praying, now's the time. Frickin' snow on the ground. Look at that. Almost April and we got snow on the ground. Well, I don't smell antifreeze. Not yet, anyway. Empty?
Hello.
That shouldn't be for a fucking thing. They just charge them $800 to put in. Yeah, actually, that's a lot.
At least the thermostat's not too hard right here.
Where the fuck did the antifreeze go? There's no antifreeze in it. That could explain why he's having problems with the heat.
Got the thermostat?
Yeah. Would it be blowing out all over the...
No, I mean, if they didn't put antifreeze in the damn thing, or not enough.
There's another problem.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think I hear something on the horizon, Jim. Do you know what it is?
Yep. It's getting closer.
I think it's because of the eye.
Yep.
That's what it's so.
Mm-hmm. I better not have to say it on the side of the fucking road tonight in the cold. That will not make
me
happy.
I'll be sleeping soundly, though. I don't know about
you. Yeah, no, you will be. I wonder if they even bothered to flush the antifreeze and they put the radiator in there. I'll flush the block anyway. Can't believe they're charging. Look, I mean, this radiator's not that hard to do.
You're probably looking at least $100 in labor.
Yeah.
Probably an hour and a half, 2 hours. So you're looking at $150 to $200 in fucking labor. Radiator's $300 to $400. Right there, you're $500 plus the antifreeze plus whatever else.
Yeah.
Plus tax. It gets up there quick. Yeah, that's one thing I painted today.
Yeah, I see it.
This I wanted. I was going to put it together, but I've got one bracket. Yeah. This, I painted this. I only have one side painted, so no. But I want to sand the back of this down because it's kind of fucked up. So I'm going to sand it lightly, new coat it, and see what it'll do.
What?
Woke up hungry.
I told you you should have got something while we were there. You think for the money they charge them, they would have put a fucking thermostat in the damn thing. fucking deal antifreeze. Did you buy antifreeze, Scott?
No.
You didn't buy antifreeze. Do these things take special antifreeze? What does that stink?
You know what I smell?
Yeah, I smell it too, and it's not good.
I smelt that many a times when I worked at Cap.
Yep.
Sorry, I hit gasket for dinner. One ringy dingy.
Carl Crum.
Yo.
This time you best call Pat.
All right, why?
Otherwise, you're just going to pay top dollar to have the same exact guy do the job. That otherwise only going to cost you half that much.
Definitely the head gasket.
That smell is
pretty damn indicative of it, to some extent.
Not a guarantee, but
too bad.
Well, just what these cars they do this.
How about looking at the thermostat? Is it any good?
Well, you can always test the thermostat.
Yeah, the boil water and shit on it. I'm not putting it with antifreeze in. I'm not putting it in my truck. My pots. There's your new one.
Right there.
At least it was easy. Jim scared me before.
Well, you know why?
Some of the thermostats are a bitch.
We've never ever had a call for a thermostat housing on one of these cars, ever. The old Hondas, yeah, from the early 90s, shit like that, late 90s. Never one of these. I don't think anybody's ever had a bad thermostat in one.
That's too bad.
That he's got a huge repair bill coming with his
thing.
Well, I just told him that he's got to call Pat because Pat's got the guy.
I've been working on this for the better part of 10 months.
Yeah.
Almost ready to go back in. That damn uncle did up here working. I do it myself. I don't want to step on any toes. One thing happens. Well, you adjusted the valves. So how long did it overheat right away after you had the
it was fine.
So what exactly blew on it? Was the radiator cracked? It was leaking a hose?
Yeah, no, I pulled in Mr. Honda. I looked down, and it was shooting out, like, and then they showed me the radiator. It was crud and so replaced.
So this car could have been running hot for quite a while there. That might have accelerated the head.
Well, it wasn't. The only thing I noticed was as soon as I came past the mobile station, and started going down the hill, and that was it, and it went. So then I replaced that, and it was fine. So I drove it around. For a few days, and that was it. And all of a sudden, had no heat, and then the thing started going up.
So, that's because it's been combusting the antifreeze, little by little, sucking it out of the radiator. And these systems don't have a shitload of capacity in them. Like the old cars are like 15 gallons of antifreeze in there. So it'd be a while if you noticed the problem. These things, they give you just the amount you need to keep the engine cool and the heat working, and that's it. Yeah, that reduces weight in the car, it reduces environmental issues and shit like that.
I mean, I have no doubt.
And of course, it reduces expenses at the factory when they have to charge them up.
I have no doubt it's probably the head gasket problem.
Well, that's a normal problem with these cars, it's just what they do.
you know, that's too bad. But
you know, like Donald, who buys all the Civics from us, he's replaced like 16 of these head gaskets. He loves buying them with blown head gaskets. There's one sitting outside my gate right now, the same damn year. Same problem. That one's got about 160,000 or something like that. But
blown head gaskets. 160, that's no good.
Well, that one may not have blown its radiator and overheated it and spiked it. So, you know, I don't know, but it has a blown head gasket. That's like this fourth or fifth one of those cars we've had with a blown head gasket. We tend to sell them all the time when they're like that, because the Honda guys love them with the blown head gaskets, because they know how to fix that. They know they can fix it. They know it's not going to be a problem with the head. It's just a gasket. Unless somebody did something really stupid, like just overheated the motherfucking piss out of it, then it might crack or warp the head or something.
The second that hatch,
yeah, you know, that's the only thing that would affect the head. There's a serious overheat, and I don't think he did that with this.
Just started doing it, and I shut it right off. I'll call Pat and just say, look, you know,
Pat, help me!
Maybe that's it. I help, yeah, exactly.
I need to go get 15 pizzas and shit. My car don't want to run. Kentucky Fried Chicken's got my picture on a milk carton.
I'm hungry.
You don't understand. Mike's having a barbecue and I'm hungry.
Barbecue, why treat you can't make a Scott? Damn, that sucks. Gotta be a little by
They always do that in Hondas. Every damn one of them is like, not in that exact spot. Some of them would have been under the air box there. Those are even more fun.
Anybody ever buy the house next door?
No.
That's the price they want for it.
And they had to put it up for what they owed on it or something, which was way too much. He fucked up because that shit. He can't get that park deal because it's not his primary residence.
Yeah.
It's his second house. He's got another house. But he can't get that shit. Just stop paying your mortgage. Go to another fucking mortgage company.
Yeah.
It must be nice to be able to take a fucking $300,000 bath.
Yeah. Well, the housing market's not really going up, it ain't really going down, right? And so it overheats on the way home, just what, open up the cap a little bit?
I don't see what that's going to do for it. Except make a mess and possibly burn it.
Well,
you.
Not open it up all the way, just open up it halfway.
Yeah.
I mean, you made it up here without a fucking
yeah.
Over. Should be able to make it.
How low was I?
I don't know. I mean, you can see the...
You can see the tubes. That's not too good for a car that just had a radiator put in a few days ago. Yeah, it should have been full.
Start her up.
A little bit on you there, Mike. He stopped. It just farted out a couple burps. A little eruption and he stopped. I wouldn't stand there while doing that.
Not that hot yet.
No, but it did spit some shit out.
Is the heat on?
No.
Thank you.
not overheating. Faithful.
Fan kicked on or something did. Should be giving him some heat by now.
Oh, yeah. Not overheating, though.
up.
No. Fucking antifreeze coming back, be selling 50% fucking water.
It's what?
It's 50% fucking water. It's pre-mixed. Water. So they're really getting a half a gallon of antifreeze is what it really is, in theory. We gotta start pissing in that thing, or? I say we gotta start pissing in the radiator. I'll go drink some more. Like a Red Dawn there.